Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, good whatever time of day it is and whatever part of the world you're at. Welcome back. And today, we're going to continue our lesson on the transformations of quadratic equations written in the vertex form. But now, we're going to look at it from the stance of them, you know, giving written directions how to write the equation. Okay? So let's just go ahead and jump on it. Number 13 says, translate the parent function 2 units to the right. Well, if we do that, that would just constitute y equals x minus 2 squared. And let me rewrite that squared part a little better. Okay, so if it's just shifted to the right 2 units, and that's x minus 2, okay? Now, let's say if it was number 14 says shift the parent function. And here's the parent function, y equals x squared. Shift the parent function up 5 units. So 5 units up. So that would simply just be y equals x squared plus 5, okay? Number 15 says, what if the parent function was translated 3 units to the left and 4 units down? Well, 3 units to the left would be x plus 3. And 4 units down would be minus 4, okay? So that would be y equals x plus 3 squared minus 4. Now, what if the parent function was translated 7 units to the right and 4 units up? Okay, like it says in number 16, 7 units to the right and 4 units up. Well, it's going to be plus 4 on the outside, and it's going to be minus 7 on the inside. And that should be y equals. So y equals x minus 7 squared plus 4, all right? Number 17. It says that the parent function has been reflected over the x-axis and then translated 3 units down. So a reflection means that it's going to be, a is negative. So it's going to be a negative x squared and shifted 3 units down would be minus 3. Okay, because we didn't have any horizontal movement, a left or a right movement. We just had a vertical movement, which was down. Number 18, it says the parent function is reflected over the x-axis, then translated to the right 5 units and 2 units down. So this would be y equals negative and then x minus 5 squared minus 2. Okay, the minus 5 gives us the translated to the right, and the minus 2 gives us the translated down. Okay, 2 units down. Alright, let's take a look at number 19. Number 19 says it was the function is vertically compressed by a factor of 1/3 and then translated up 3 units. So, vertically compressed means that A is now equal to 1/3, so that's 1/3 x squared, and shifted up means plus 8. Okay, and now the last one, number 20. Number 20 reads, the function is vertically stretched by a factor of 2 and then reflected over the x-axis and translated to the left. All right, so that was a mouthful, but we'll take it one step at a time. So reflection means that it's negative. A factor of 2 means that A is equal to negative 2 because it had to be reflected. Then since it's shifted to the left, we're going to have our parentheses, and that's going to be x plus 4. And we don't have any shift up or down, so that would just be squared. And no plus or minus a number. So our final answer would be y equals negative 2 times the group of x plus 4 squared. Okay? And that is how we write the equations based on the transformations of the graph.